Okay, now this topic coming with what is state or what is known as thermodynamic state. So state of any system can be expressed like this way, that basically properties are need to know if you want to specify the state of any substance, because those properties are the coordinates to describe the state of a system. That is the main catch line of that particular thing. So I can write like this: properties, what are these properties? Already I have explained. So properties are the coordinates to describe the state of a system. That means if we know the property of that any particular system, then you can specify that what is the state of that particular system. Is it in a solid state or liquid state or semi-solid or gaseous or a mixture? What kind of state actually belonging that particular system, that can be specified if you know the needful properties of that particular system. Okay, also I can write like this way, that any operation, or I can say that state is specified or described by its properties, or rather I can say some macroscopic properties, rather saying macroscopic properties. Now one thing, obviously it will come in your mind, that what is this macroscopic properties? Macroscopic properties, nothing but all those properties of the system which we can measure or which we can sense or which we can be perceived by our senses. Okay, some properties like pressure, like temperature, like volume, these are some macroscopic properties. I can write some examples: pressure in short, volume or temperature. These are some properties or density which are basically known as macroscopic properties, because they can be sensed or they can be measured easily by our senses. They can be sensed, or some using some instrument they can be measured also. Okay, so these macroscopic properties, if we know them, then you can specify a property of a system. Obviously, if there is some macroscopic property, obviously there will be some microscopic properties. Microscopic properties means some molecular level properties. Suppose for a substance, obviously we all know that for any substance, molecular motions will be changing with the supply or addition of any energy. Suppose you are supplying any heat on any particular solid, then that solid is going to be transferred into semi-solid, then liquid. Obviously some molecular changes are going to be occur inside. Okay, so the momentum or the velocity of those molecules will going to be increase, or if you cool down those substance, it will decrease. That's why the molecular behavior will going to be changed when you are supplying or when you are rejecting any energy from that substance. So from that molecular point of view, the change of properties, a change of behavior of those molecules are known as microscopic properties. Like we can say that microscopic properties, obviously they are not very easy to measure, or they are not very easy to perceive by our senses. Microscopic properties. So microscopic properties can be explained like, examples can be velocity. Speed can be measured very easily, but velocity cannot be measured very easily. So, or rather say, some more example can be put on like velocity or kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, because it is also related with velocity. Velocity is a molecular microscopic property, then obviously kinetic energy also is a kind microscopic property, as well as momentum. These are basically microscopic properties, because they are not very easily measured by some instruments and our senses cannot feel them. So that's why they are basically dealing with the molecular behavior. That's why they are known as microscopic property. So these microscopic property are not going to be used to specify a state, mind it. They are not useful to specify the state of any system, mind it. But these macroscopic properties like this, they are very essential to specify the state of any system. Understood? So that is the state. Try to know that what is state, then obviously there will be coming a thing that is change of state, obviously, because we are very frequently used with this change of state. So any operation in which one or more of the properties of a system changes is called change of state. So from any state, suppose it's solid to liquid or liquid to gas, if that kind of change of state is occurring, then we can say that one or more, I written over here that one or more, for which case only one property is essential to specify the change of state, and in which case more than one property is essential to specify the change of state, that is, that can be determined with the help of Gibbs phase rule. So Gibbs phase rule, when it will come, I can explain that point of time. But from this point, you should know that if you want to specify the change of state, then at least one or more than one, which property? Macroscopic properties are needed to specify a change of state. Okay, if a state is a definite state is there, that means no change of state is occurring, then all these macroscopic properties having a fixed value. I should write it also that if a definite state is there, if a definite state is existing, then we can say the macroscopic properties, what happens? Macroscopic properties having a fixed value, that means they are not going to vary if the state is definite. That means a fixed state is there. Fixed value, the properties will be having a fixed value. If any of these properties is going to be changed, at least one property is going to be changed, that means the change of state is occurring. I can put an example over here that suppose I had one atmospheric pressure means normal atmospheric pressure, and that means it is actually, it is not exactly one, it is 1.01325 bar, that is closely equal to one, that's why it is written one atmospheric pressure. And 0 degree centigrade water in solid state, because it is in ice condition. Now if we maintain the pressure same at one atmospheric pressure, that means normal atmospheric pressure, if we increase the temperature like 120 degree centigrade, so it will be then gaseous state. So obviously by putting this kind of easy example, for water it is known to us, that's why I'm writing for water. So keeping one macroscopic property constant, but the other one is changing, the temperature is changing, you can see the state change of state is occurring. So that is the state change of state, macroscopic property, microscopic property. I think it is clear to you. Then moving on to the next topic. Okay, next topic is path. So thermodynamic path. Thermodynamic path is nothing but the series of states. Already we know that what is state. So series of state passed through by the system during any change. Suppose one change of state is occurring. I already gave an example from water liquid state to ice solid state. Now when this transformation or change of state is occurring, then each and every point, if you take those macroscopic properties and if you join them with a line, it can be curved, it can be straight, then that will be specified by its path. Basically, that for just to show those paths for that change of state, we generally use to plot them in graphical manner in PV, pressure versus volume plot, or pressure versus temperature plot, or temperature versus entropy plot, or enthalpy versus entropy plot. That kind of ordinate and abscissa will be plotted. That and this x and y axis, if we assume some macroscopic property, then we just have to plot all those known macroscopic property from that initial state to the final state and join them by a kind of fitment. It can be a curve fitment, it can be a straight line fitment, then you are getting a path. Okay, so I can write it like this manner, that the series of states, series of state means a state is going to be changed from one state to another, then obviously different kind of series will occur. So that's why I am writing the series of states from liquid to solid when it is transforming. So it is not kind of a magic that within second it will be converted. Slowly it is going to be liquid, then from semi liquid, then slowly it will be plastic state, then it will be going to be in solid ice form. So that is why, that is, it is a kind of series of states. The series of states passed through by the system, any system you can consider. I am not talking about only water and ice, any system you can consider. By the system during a change of state, or rather say during a change of one equilibrium state, on change of one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state. Now obviously one question again coming, what is this equilibrium state? Equilibrium state is nothing but that a system, if it is in equilibrium state, then we can say that no properties will not change without some perceivable effect in surrounding. That means without any considerable effect in surrounding. That means suppose for any particular state point, if that particular state point, the pressure, temperature, all these macroscopic properties or enthalpy, entropies are constant, if we consider, if we assume, then that particular state point is known as equilibrium state. Okay, so if we want to plot, suppose I can say also that this path can be viewed, basically we can show, can be viewed, or you can be the, you can be, it can be viewed by graphical manner, by graphical manner on a pressure versus volume, or rather say in bracket I can write the symbol also, because the symbol are very frequently used, capital P versus capital V, then pressure versus temperature, or I can write the symbol also PT, or temperature versus entropy, temperature versus entropy in bracket T versus S. S is a symbol of entropy, it will come later also, and enthalpy, enthalpy versus entropy in brackets capital H to S, capital H used for symbolize the enthalpy, and capital S enthalpy symbolized for entropy. So this path is basically can be visualized with the help of this kind of graphical manner. Suppose I plot a kind of pressure to temperature for any kind of substance. I am putting an example just. Okay. Also, so pressure, when you have suppose a kind of fitment, this kind of point you are getting, each and every cross is basically indicating one equilibrium state, mind it. So suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When temperature is getting increased, I am considering the pressure is getting dropped. So if I fit, or if I join all those equilibrium state point by this kind of a fitment, I am again saying, is it a straight line fitment or curve fitment, that I am not going to discuss over here, that depending on the equation particularly. Okay, I am assuming an arbitrary example. So when this every state point we consider their equilibrium state, because at this particular point we are considering that all those macroscopic property, here pressure and temperature remain constant, and if you join them, then you are getting the path. That is the path, whatever you can see over here, or it can be known as a pressure volume plot. That kind of plot will be going to be used very frequently for specifying different kind of paths, or for different kind of process also. So that is the path. When you are joining this equilibrium state point, whatever you are getting, that is the path. Understood? Then after having the path, one point will come, what is process? So when the path followed by the system during a change from one equilibrium state to another, that is completely specified, initial and final conditions, interaction with surrounding is called a process. That means suppose a process on this particular plot, suppose making this kind of a thing, I got this for different state point, suppose these are all the different equilibrium state point. Okay, I can name it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so while the, I can see over here, the while the volume is getting increased, the pressure is remaining constant. Gradually volume is getting increased, but the pressure is remaining constant. So that particular path is followed by that particular system, and after following that path, we have to name the process, that what kind of process it is, what is the name of that particular path. So that is the naming process of that particular path, is the process. So here we can see it is a constant pressure process. Why it is a constant pressure process? Because we can see from the plot, the pressure is maintaining constant, and this constant pressure process is also named as isobaric baric process. Iso means equal, same, and bar is a unit of pressure. That's why it is came like that way that it is a isobaric process. Okay, so process I can define it like this: when the path followed by the system, that means any system followed by the system which is following that particular path during any change of state, then that path is named by a process. Obviously, it will be changed from one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state. I am not writing that thing. Okay, so that process is a particular proper specification of the executed path followed by the system. So a path which is following that is followed by that particular system, that path is properly specified by that name of the process. That's why that naming the path is nothing but the process. Okay, so some examples can be set over there, like constant pressure process already I have shown over there. Similarly, constant volume process is also named as isochoric process. Constant pressure, isobaric. Then constant temperature process that is known as isothermal. These terms will be remembered because they will be used frequently in subject. Okay, constant temperature process, constant enthalpy, it is also known as isenthalpic process, constant entropy process is known as isentropic. These are the some name of the processes by which you are specifying a path. So if you say that it is a constant pressure process, then already anybody who is familiar with these things, he will understand the path which is followed by that particular system, it will be parallel with the volume axis and perpendicular with the pressure axis. That way, this name of this path is very important, that what kind of nature actually you are going to plot on the Cartesian plane, that is specified by this name. Suppose if anybody says you that it is a constant volume process or isochoric process, so obviously you can if you name it by pressure versus volume plot, and if anybody told you that it is a constant volume process, then obviously it will be a vertical line like this manner. I'm trying to write a vertical line, but it's skidding actually, like this manner. So obviously the state points macroscopic properties are known to you. So if this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then you can say it is a constant volume process, because you can see that increasing of pressure or decreasing of pressure, it doesn't change in the value of volume. So it is an isochoric process. So that's why the name of this path which is followed by this different equilibrium state points, that is very important to specify properly that path executed by that system. Okay, so that is the process. Again, moving on, Next topic is cycle, or rather say thermodynamic cycle. Thermodynamic cycle is nothing but a series of process. And one thing should be remembered in case of cycle, that if the initial, the starting point of that particular process and the final or end point of that particular process, if they are same, initial and final, if they are same, then we can say that this whole process is a kind of cycle. Okay, it can be only two process, only one process is executing and that is a cycle, it is not possible. At least two or more than two processes must be there to complete a cycle. That means initial and the final state point will be remain same. So I can write like this way, it is a process in which initial and final state points are same, then we can say it is a cycle. It is a cycle, and obviously it consists, if it is a cycle, then it consists two or more than two processes must be there. It can be two or more than two process. Okay, so two or more processes must be there whose actually state of the, how that process actually working, that the initial state point and the final state point will be kind of a same point. Okay, so it can be plotted in a graphical manner. Suppose I am plotting PV plot. So suppose any kind of process I can show, that suppose this is a state point 1 and this is a state point 2. Okay, so from 1 to 2 the process is moving like this, then from 2 to 1 again it is coming back to its initial point. So that's why it is a cycle. You can see more than one process, that is two process can be there, so two process is complete a cycle. So also I can show you like a PV plot of a more than two process. Suppose if it is a look like this one, which kind of cycle it is, and that can be clarified later in your future days, so it will be coming. Suppose 1, 2, 3 and 4, this is a kind of cycle. You can say, see over here that the initial state point at the 1, from 2 it is moving, then 2 to 3, then 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. There are different processes are there. That is 1 to 2, it is a isentropic process, then 2 to 3, it is a constant volume process, then 3 to 4 again isentropic expansion, 1 to 2 was isentropic compression, and 4 to 1 it is constant volume process also. But different processes can be there, but you have to remember, if the initial state point and the final state point, they are coming at the same point. You can see from 1 it has been started, and again after completion of all those 4 processes they are coming back to the 1. That's why it is known as a cycle. Okay, so moving to next topic,